We moved out here because we wanted to feel safe. And the opposite's happening. Never felt more unsafe in my life.
Are you by chance a fan of this, the Netflix show The Watcher? Millions of people apparently have been tuning in, and it's also having an impact on home buyers. The horror show is based on a real life story of an anonymous stalker who terrorizes a family. So now, as a result, people want to know, who are my new neighbors going to be? Is there anything spooky about this house I should know? And has someone died in it? Jim Stalwart is with Better Homes and Gardens Real Estate and joins us now to discuss. Jim, good morning to you. Thanks for joining us. Yes, I have not seen this show, but I can only imagine it is making people a little unnerved, right? So how is this show affecting you as a realtor when you're trying to sell a house?
Well, you know, a lot of people are starting to ask more questions like, who's the neighbors? What's going on in the neighborhood? Has anything happened in the house that I need to know about? But quite honestly, that's something that we've always been doing is when we have a buyer that likes a house, the best thing you can do is we'll go to the neighbors and knock on the door and say, hey, these people are thinking about being your new neighbors. Anything special about the house we should know? Can you tell us great things about the neighborhood? You know, it goes into there's certain things we can and can't disclose. Some things we will just don't know, but mm-hmm. The greatest source of information is usually going to be the neighbors.
Okay. Well, let me ask you this then. There are certain things you cannot disclose. What can you disclose? What if I want to know, did someone die in that house? Is that house haunted? Has there been any issues? How much can you tell me, or how much can we find out together?
You know, that depends if you're the buyer's agent or the seller's agent. On the seller's agent, we don't legally have to disclose anything that the seller doesn't want us to disclose something as far as somebody died in there or something like that. Then as the seller's agent, we can't disclose that because it's not a legal issue for us to, it doesn't affect the value of the property. As a buyer's agent though, if we know about something, it's not law, but it's our realtor's code of ethics, and we hold that very dear. So we definitely, as realtors, want to protect our clients' interest. You know, I had some buyers once that were purchasing a home, and I said, well, you've got your contract. Let's go out tomorrow, and it's going to be Saturday. Let's knock on some of the doors and ask. And we did find out that the husband had committed suicide in the basement, and the neighbors were so happy that somebody was going to be buying the house from the widow. And the buyers did back out of the house. They weren't comfortable with that. Uh-huh. So as a buyer's agent, we're going to disclose everything we can to protect our buyer's interest, not just their finances.
Okay, so what if, let's say, you as realtors, you guys all talk amongst each other. Say the house on Maple and whatever street is known to have maybe some spirits that have been left over. You, in this case, you're not representing the seller, you are representing the buyer. Do you even take them there? What do you say to them before you go there?
I'm gonna let them know, like, hey, if it doesn't bother you, you're gonna get a good deal on this house because nobody wants it. They say there's ghosts in there. The house I bought, the two previous owners died in it. It's fine, you know, it's uh-huh. It's okay. We're okay with it.
Yeah.
We say hi to the ghost once in a while.
you have a friendly ghost, and not everybody can make sure that that's going to happen. Okay, so what do you want people to know, bottom line, when it comes to purchasing a home, when it comes to buyer beware, even going beyond maybe, spirits or dead people, when it comes to any issues like flooding or leaking or anything, what do you want people to know? What homework do they need to do?
You know, flooding, leaking, anything like that, that's going to be covered, at least in Illinois, by state law and on the seller's property disclosure. So there's repercussions and you're protected on that. The sellers are going to, they're supposed to, you know, by law, disclose anything that they know about reoccurring flooding and such like that. But as far as ghosts and goblins, they're going to come around on October 31st, I guess. But if we don't know about that, I'm going to say it comes down to if it's going to cost you money to fix, these sellers have to disclose it. If it's just a feeling, et cetera, then as a buyer's agent, anything that we know, we're going to do our best to protect your interest and let you know about it, let you make your decision.
Okay, Jim Stalwart with Better Homes and Gardens Real Estate. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
You take care.